So I make it through the 24 hours, and the next morning my wife drives me to the hospital, and we're sitting there in the waiting room, and she's flipping through a People magazine, could care less. I'm looking at who's in the room with me, and it's not a pretty sight. There's some old dude over here whose head's lolled off to the side, he's drooling. There's another guy over here hacking up a lung, and I'm just like, oh my God, this is where I'm headed. All of a sudden, the orderly walks in and goes, Mr. Engvall. And I go, yeah. And he goes, come with me. So I leaned over and kissed my wife goodbye. And he led me into this curtained off area. It's these little compartments that are curtained off. And he goes, why don't you go ahead and get undressed, put that paper robe on. Oh, leave it open in the back. Thanks, forgot why I was here. Jackass. So I'm laying there on this bed on this paper robe, and it's just awful, and I keep hearing this noise, and I don't know what it is, and it's driving me crazy. And I finally, it hits me. The noise is guys on either side of the curtains from me farting. And I don't mean cute little Jimmy squeezed out of toot farts. I'm talking about bullfrogs getting run over by a Mack truck. Just disgusting, like... And that was usually followed by some voice going, that's good, Papa. That's what the doctor wants you to do. And I'm just laying there going, oh my God, that's gonna be me. The nurse comes around the curtain and she goes, I've seen you on TV. She goes, I'm just gonna put an IV and check your blood pressure. And I go, fine. So she puts the IV in, she starts taking my blood pressure and she goes, are you okay? And I go, yeah, I'm fine. Why? And she goes, well, your blood pressure seems a little high. And I go, really? I was just laying there trying to remember the last time I had something inserted in that area. Oh, I remember. Never! Yes, I'm a little uptight right now. I go, what's the IV for? And she goes, well, when we get you in there, we're going to give you a little something to relax you. I go, bonus. So she goes, I'm going to go get the room ready. The doctor will be in just a minute. So I'm laying there amongst the chorus of frogs. And the doctor comes around the corner, and she is gorgeous. Remember who set this up? And the doctor says, well, I hear we have a celebrity in here today. I'm like, are you kidding me? I can't get recognized in a topless bar to get a free lap dance, but oh my God. Shove something up my rear end. Everybody knows he's in town. Maybe he'll sign autographs. So the doctor explains to me what's gonna go on. I said, I'll see you in the other room. She goes, it's a date. And I went, and she said, I can have that looked at. And I go, no, just go, go. So they come and they get me and they wheel me past the frogs. And we go into this operating room. And the nurse walks over and squirts this stuff in my IV. And literally within a second, I was just, hello. And she goes, hi back. And I went, hi back? That didn't even make sense. Hi back.
Hi, nurse.
Oh my God. I can't feel my face.
Hey.
It's attached.
Hey, I have a question.
What was that?
She goes, it's a little cocktail I mixed up for you. And I go, well, bartender, I'll have a double.
And I knew I was in this Demerol haze because I looked over and there was the scope. That camera thing they were gonna insert in my body, and it didn't scare me. What scared me is when I looked down the floor and I saw the cord coiled up like a rope. I'm like, oh my God! Because I know I was gonna come out of this Demerol haze and see some janitor stand there going, all right.
Yeah.
I'd be like, oh my God, did I take all that? Oh yeah, almost chipped your tooth.
Well, the next thing I know, I'm out. And it seemed like a second later, it'd actually been like an hour and a half, but now I'm in another room and I'm dressed.
Wait a minute. I was in that room, I was naked. Now I'm in this room and I'm dressed and I don't remember anything. My wife comes around the corner, she goes, you okay, baby? And I go, mm-hmm. I go, did you dress me? And she goes, no. Was it that bartender? And she goes, what? No, she goes, you dressed yourself. And I go, when? And she goes, like 20 minutes ago. And I'm like, I didn't do too bad. She goes, no. She goes, look, I'm gonna go sign you out, then we'll go home. And I go, okay. I go, I go, one more thing. Did I fart? And she goes like a beached whale. Super. So I've been sitting on the edge of this bed and I feel fine. Well, she comes back around the curtain. She goes, all right, you're all signed out. Let's go home. And I hopped off that bed and y'all, it looked like a baby giraffe being born. It was just... She is literally holding onto my belt loop screaming, focus on the door, Otis, focus on the door. And as we're staggering out of the hospital, I don't remember doing this because I was still high, but apparently I turned to the entire operating room staff and screamed, hey, I better not see this on YouTube. God bless you guys. Thank you very much.